Hello guys, today I want to pay your attention to Laravel validation and how Laravel validation returns the error if you want to consume that in the Vue.js, for example, or any frontend. Because the structure is not really trivial and there are some actions needed how to parse that on the frontend, for example, in the Vue.js. And I have an example project, which is actually a blog article which I've written a few months ago on my blog laraveldaily.com. I also have a video version and I will link all of that in the description below. And while demonstrating the CRUD with Composition API, I was, to be honest, too lazy to parse the errors. And sometime later, I received a pull request in that free repository with a better implementation of errors. So how does it work? In the Vue.js code, if you do Axios post to some post request, if the validation error happens, you should catch the error status 422, right? HTTP status code for validation, which is returned by default from Laravel API. And on Laravel API side, there's nothing really magic here. Store method, company request is a form request class with validation rule, so it didn't override any Laravel default behavior. So by default, the structure of errors returned is pretty complex. There's the response, then there's data, and then there's errors, and that errors is array. Let's take a look. So if we open the browser here on the left, in the right-hand side we have network, and if we create with all the validation errors, all four fields are required or invalid, and look what happens here. The actual response is message, then errors, and then the errors is an object, and each object element is an array of potential errors. So errors, address, and then zero element, the address must be a string. So to parse that into the left-hand side, this is required, that is required, the Vue.js code looks like this. So we have errors variable property, right? And then in the Vue.js component, if we have errors, then we do v4 of those errors. So each of those elements represent one field. And then we need to do for each of the fields, for each of the error in v. So that v is actually, let's rename it, so field like this. That is probably more readable. And only in here you have validation error. So you have to do for each, and also those errors come from Axios response, then data, and then errors. That whole structure makes sense if you think about it, but it's quite complex and not really trivial to parse on the Vue.js, so I thought to shoot this video. And if you want to view full example, check out the article or the video. I will link it all in the description below. And also there's GitHub repository. If we scroll down at the very end of the article, there's the repository, including that pull request, this one. I'm thinking to shoot more videos about Vue.js and Laravel in 2022. So if you have any questions around that topic, please shoot in the comments below, and see you guys in other videos.